Hey folks, welcome back to the channel. Today's episode, I'm going to carry you along and bring you up to speed on a project that I've been working on. I've not shown it much on YouTube, but it's fixing to get its own little series, easier for you to follow. Let's see what it is. Sent a comment in wanting to know what the cab was, what that chassis was. Behind me is a 1955 Chevy pickup truck. Extensive body work, rust repair, you name it. The truck has had it and has gone through it. I guess we're just going to call this episode one of that series, but I'm going to carry you all the way through until the truck's finished. So you guys are going to be part of that. I appreciate all the comments. It's because of those comments is the reason that I'm doing this. So thank you so much for being part of this channel and sticking with me and helping us grow. So here we go. Let's get into the episode. This is the 55 Chevy pickup truck's rear fender. Everything you see there that's dark was a dent. It was terrible. I've got most of them smooth. You can see where I've circled a few more that I need to work on with a graphite pencil. And this will be okay to do body work over. It won't bleed through later. But most of them that have that I've dollied out, I've gone back and knocked them down. That one still has a little bit more to come out. I didn't got that one out far enough yet. But anyway, most of them look just like that right there. I dollied them out from behind with a hammer and a dolly and did all of my metal work. It's gonna still need body work. I'm not that good and that stuff takes a lot of time and that's what body filler's for. But at this point, instead of having a half inch worth of body filler on a dent that I've ground off half inch, almost 3/4 inches of body filler off of this fender, along with about 14 coats of paint. You might ask why I didn't buy new fenders. Well, right now, the last year and a half, about all you can get are the fenders that are blems that somebody else couldn't sell, so they probably need more work than this. They might be dent-free, but they fit awful. And I'm sure some of you have been there. You can see there's some dents that I've still, that's one of the ones I've got circled that I haven't done yet. And this long crease right here, I've dollied it out most of the way. It had a big divot in it. And if it has a straight edge, well, a straight edge isn't gonna work really good on a curved surface, but you can see that you can almost not see any light underneath it when it rolls. So we're close. I can still feel a little bit. But anyway, just gonna bring you up to speed on this truck. And a lot of it's painted. A lot of it's ready for paint. All right, here's the fender after the majority of the body work. From here, it'll get a direct metal primer and then a high build primer. And then start blocking it down and guide coating it and see where I still have body work to work. I can't explain to you how much Bondo was in this fender. At least a gallon of Bondo, probably in just this one fender. And now it's just skim coated. And it is probably gonna get another slight skim coat, but we're not trying to do pottery and sculpt something out of a gallon bucket of Bondo. So, when this thing's in primer, I'm gonna show you what it looks like. There's the firewall. Had a lot of rust and stuff in the firewall where somebody had put a motor in it at one time that was probably too big for the truck and pushed it all in and hammered it all in. But anyway, I think I've, I don't know, there's probably about 40, 50 holes in the firewall. and got rid of every one of them except for the factory braces. And of course, that's about it. We'll end up putting some holes in over here for heater hoses, you know, a four-way block, heater and AC. Other than that, the firewall is not overly done. A lot of the character, factory character, has been left in it. And I just made panels for all the different inserts and stuff. Instead of it being completely smooth, you know, give it some character, leave it original. But anyway, this should be a really, really nice truck, and really looking forward to getting it finished. All right, here's the cab. You've seen it probably in another video or two. It has had final prime and blocked, guide coated and blocked, prime, guide coated and blocked on everything except for the doors. The doors have been primed, blocked, body worked. They're ready for primer again, and then they're probably close to being paint ready. You know, just need to get the guide coat after them, and ready to go. They haven't been primed on the inside yet. Dash has already been painted. Inside's been jammed in. Cleared the back wall, and then I have blocked down the clear on the back wall again, because it had a little bit too much texture in it and it's gonna be hard to buff. So I went ahead and knocked the texture out of the clear, and I'm gonna hit it with another coat and maybe have to keep from buffing it. Dash turned out really, really well. But the doors, waited a long time for the hinges on the doors, got them in, got all the body gaps and everything good on the doors, because that door's not shut, but it's got a nice body gap all the way around it. But anyway, that's where we're at today. Well, guys, if you made it to that video, I sure appreciate it. It was a little boring, but it was some video clips that I had taken over the last few months. And then I did a catch-up video of where that project sits now. And from now on, I'm going to carry you guys along with me as we finish that truck out. It was a little boring, but that's all I had to work with to bring that project into scope. And I appreciate the viewers that noticed the project in the background and wanted to see more. So from now on, you're going to see more, and it's going to be more interesting. So as always, thanks for following us. Thanks for watching the channel. Thanks for all the support. Thanks for the comments and the likes. And most of all, just thanks for being my friend. Now, with that said, get off the couch, get out in the garage, and go make something. Till next time, thanks for watching.